Welcome back to the Talos Principle. I've completed 1, 2, and 3. So let's move on to number 4. And this should give me the pieces I need to unlock the box. Also, I just realized this has the things I just unlocked before, or the thing I just unlocked before, in it, which I'm assuming means I need those to actually be able to complete this part. Okay. So I think I'm gonna get to play with a new tool. Cool.
These worlds, and we within them, are made of words. Hidden words, invisible to you, yet part of all things. We are a story. Your actions give life to the story, and the story gives meaning to your life.
I'm not really sure what to make of that. It's very peaceful. Too bad it's all fake. What if I fell down there? Would I die? I'd probably die. But does death have any meaning? Not really. Okay, let's not go down there. Beginnings. Huh, this is a .txt file. Stratton of Stagira on beginnings. It is the grave error of many philosophers, not only of the Athenian schools, but also of many others, that they begin not with observation of the cosmos as it surrounds us, but with a conclusion already in mind. And often that conclusion is that the world was created ideal, and mankind itself the greatest creation of the gods. Yet neither the world nor the gods owe mankind perfection. It is arrogance itself to presume so, and contrary to all the methods of philosophy. The honest philosopher seeks only the truth, even if it bears no comfort, and he must begin by assuming, as Socrates said, that all he knows is that he knows nothing. Progress report. Was sent to the Ian mailing list. Nadia Serapi. What was her job again? Hold on, before I even read this, I just want to keep this stuff straight. The Institute Coordinator, okay. Hi, all. Everything's been moved to the EL facility. I know it's been sad to leave the good old Jeff building behind, but it makes sense for us to be on-site, especially as there may be severe power outages in the coming weeks. Arcady's team are already working something. But you really don't need to worry about the teams getting in each other's way. The facility is genuinely humongous. Let's get the show on the road. There may be severe power outages in the coming weeks. I'm guessing that's as a result of whatever bad thing or stuff was happening on the outside world. Or in the outside world, to be grammatically correct. Error. I was sent to pretty much everybody, 504 recipients. I'll keep this short. You all know me, so you know that I know what I'm talking about. I realize that you're all working on projects meant to somehow avert... It's always corrupted in such a way as to obscure what the thing is, isn't it? find a solution. Preserve the non-biological components of... Not in terms of... Immediately you'll find the details of my proposal in the attachment, but the short version is global undertaking. Is it a coincidence that those... the most important parts happen to be corrupted? That's quite the coincidence. I don't believe it. But then again, if something was deliberately corrupting that stuff, then why didn't it just corrupt everything? Why even leave fragments? Preserve the non-biological components of something. Well, this is right after saying find a solution. So I'm assuming this is the stated solution. Probably like, I believe that something is, you know, may be able to solve the problem, something preserve the non-biological components. I don't know.
I speak unto the darkness, be gone. Excess data cleared.
Excess data? So whatever that was the darkness. Is somebody trying to hack the system? Or something? Or is that just data corruption? What's this excess data? Does that mean everything's gotten so large that they're running out of storage space and that was a purge to keep everything running? If anyone ever reads this, the trick is seeing the assumptions you're making about the mechanics, and reassessing them. Good luck. Naming function error. Well, either that person picked a very clever name, or that just did not print their name properly. Hello, recording. I wonder if any of these are actual people, you know? Is this game entirely single player, or is there some sort of multiplayer component? Maybe Dark Souls-esque? You know, fragments? Maybe the recordings are of other people? Hmm. I think I can actually do a little bit of platforming here. There might be something here. In fact, there could even be a star. Okay, that just leads back here. Yeah, because I can jump and run very fast. Ah! Where is this going? Oh, that can't be the end. Can I jump? Yeah, I can jump that. This must lead somewhere. Well, I could have just walked up to here, so that's not really helpful. Whoa! didn't want me to be there, apparently. Just pushed me away. Looks like this lower rim thing just kind of continues around the whole place. Well, let's keep exploring. Just looking for like a secret button or like a cave hidden behind the bushes. Carved into the rock face. Aw, it ends. Or does it? Ugh. I know I can do that. Come on. I can probably just go up there and probably drop down to here. Shit. No, I'm back here. Alright, let's see if I can just drop down to it. I probably can. It's not as cool. Bunny hop, bunny hop, bunny hop, bunny hop. Where exactly was I? I think I was right there. Yeah, I can just drop down. What is that? Looks like a volleyball or something. I don't think there's anything around the rim. God damn it! Sometimes if you hit a rock, it just like pushes you away, like there's a rocket strapped to your ass or something. Weird. There's some sort of code in the game, like something about the character movement, the character controller that, like, it tries to push you off of stuff. Oftentimes. I guess if they don't intend for you to actually be on it. It gets a little bit overzealous.
The answer that came to me again and again was play. Every human society in recorded history has games. We don't just solve problems out of necessity. We do it for fun. Even as adults. Leave a human being alone with a knotted rope, and they will unravel it. Leave a human being alone with blocks, and they will build something. Games are part of what makes us human. We see the world as a mystery, a puzzle, because we've always been a species of problem solvers.
That does seem to reinforce what I was thinking. I can't remember exactly what gave me this impression, but something gave me the impression that this whole thing was just a, like, throwing artificial intelligences against the problem, hoping that they'll find the solution for them, basically. And that would seem to reinforce that idea. But how is what I'm doing going to solve anything? I don't even know what the problem is that we're supposedly supposed to solve. Let alone how solving these little puzzles could possibly be the answer. It's like, yeah, I figured out how to put the jammer in the place and disable the minigun. Like, how the hell does that map to whatever their problem was? A problem apparently so hard that they couldn't solve it on their own? And hold on, what was her name?
The answer that came to me again and again was play.
That's strange. It doesn't actually say the person's name anymore. It only said it when I first picked it up. It was like Alex... something... Let me check. I'll recognize it. Oh, it was... Yeah, Alexander. Alexandra Drennan. Project Lead AI Module. Ooh, what is that? Whoa. I could have easily missed that. I was just thinking, this is the end of the line. I was going to express my disappointment, but apparently it's not. Bunny hop, bunny hop, bunny hop, bunny hop. Ah, super fast FPS controls. Yeah. Whee! I know this looks horrible with video compression, but god, it's fun. Wait, where was it? Oh, it's down there. Are you kidding me? God damn it! I didn't forget to jump, but just like, I started to skate on the rocks like I was on ice. I like a lot of things about this game, but the character controller is a little bit finicky. There we go. Okay. Looks like it's tuned to a frequency. Could that frequency be important? Just in case, I'm gonna write it down. 45, 46, 2.
Sam, have you reached the Sphinx yet? We've translated one of the lines, but we still don't have a solution. It says the true riddle of the Sphinx has many questions, but only one answer.
I have no idea what that's talking about. I can't even hear that again. Jesus, I wish I wrote it down. Thankfully I have it recorded, but I'd have to go back and look at the recording. The riddle of the Sphinx has many questions but only one answer? One answer, many questions? What even was that? I think she said Sam? Who's called Sam? Who's Sam? Is there a Sam? Didn't she say Sam? I don't see anyone called Sam. Although that person's name is messed up, so who knows what their name is. Just like the QR codes, that's gonna have to be something that I do off-screen after I'm done recording, and then hopefully make sense of it later. Yeah, so I'm actually gonna transcribe that. Let me make a note for myself here. Transcribe. Okay, so I'm gonna transcribe whatever that said, and I'm gonna put it in the comments, both for you and for myself. Interesting, there's so many mysteries around. Really pays off to explore. And think about how many things I might be missing by running around here. I just want to look behind every rock. Okay, so this drives home the fact that it is worth it to do a full circuit of this little outside rim place. So let's give this place a full rim job. I mean, scratch that. I've almost made a full circuit of this place. I wonder if there's any other walkie-talkies. I mean, how did that get there, though? I'm assuming that's something I'm not supposed to find. So how did that get there? Was it something that was supposed to be cleaned up by Elohim, but he just missed it? Oh my god. Stupid, bouncy, freaking rocks. I hate you. I'm gonna spend this entire episode not even solving a single damn puzzle. Cause this is satisfying enough. Alright, let's not jump on the rocks, they're dangerous. Alright, I think this is where I was, right? Yeah. Let's just reset. It's actually faster. And this is the other side, so... Wait, is this the other side? I don't think it is, actually. No, this is the other side. Okay. Yep, so I think that's it for the rim. Bunny hop, bunny hop, bunny hop, bunny hop. Let's go solve a puzzle! Whee! Ah, right, my new toy. What the hell is that thing? Guess it's related to my new toy. Perhaps it's a stationary... stationary jamming beam, which is why I need the reflector thingy. Mmm. Oh, that feels good. Point at another target. Connect. Interesting. Do I have to connect it to all of them? No. Can I connect it to as many as I want? I can connect it in between. Right, so that's my source. So then what if I did like this, and then I went behind so that I couldn't reach it? It's gonna, like, unselect it. Yeah, someone's gone gray. Oh, hello. So that's three, although that one's gray too, so I guess I can't go through the bars. Can I melt the bars with that? Alright, so it's just a connector. It doesn't care what you're actually connecting to. So whether you connect it to two things that are just receivers, and therefore don't receive anything, or if you can connect it to something that actually outputs something and to a receiver, yeah, it doesn't care. It just connects. And there's one up there, and it's already connected to that. So obviously I can't actually reach up there to get it, so what I do need to do is actually connect the connector to another connector. Okay. That's pretty cool. Any secrets around here? Stars? I just want to throw myself at different walls to see whether I can just, like, break through it. Inside. Well, that wasn't very hard. Okay, so I'm probably gonna have to use these to go around a corner, I think. Yep. So I can't go through the bars, right? No. If I select this and then something else, will it automatically... Yeah. Okay. So I don't need to, like, make this thing point to this thing, I can just make this thing point to that thing. Companion cube! I mean, non-copyright infringing rectangular object. Don't cross the streams. Okay, so we have bad beams here. Oh no, those aren't bad beams. Just need the appropriate color to go into the appropriate thingy. What if you put it in the wrong one? Does it explode? Nah, just doesn't work. Okay, well, the beams cancel each other out. So... Oh. There we go. Let's get some wonky angles going on here. There we go. Cool. Look at that. Hey, I'm starting to unlock the fan. It's another thing I saw in that little, like, test bed place filled with those creepy, weird people. Yeah, what was there? There's a cube, there's a reflection thing, there was a fan, I don't know if there's anything else. Crossing streams again. Okay, two connectors. How in the hell do I solve this problem? It's called above all that. Can I, like, put the connector so above on something? I can't even jump up on this damn thing. I suppose I could just put it up here. What if I do that? Oh, it just meets halfway in the middle. And there we go. Alright, I think that's all of them for here. But I want to take a look around for QR codes and perhaps any elusive stars that I probably will never find. Yeah, I think that's it. Okay, so I've explored the outside edge of this place. Let's look at the inside. There's a code. Oh wait, I've already read that. The trick is seeing the assumptions you're making about the mechanics and reassessing them. Hello, recording. You're looking very blue today. You're looking very non-existent today. What assumptions am I making about the mechanics? I don't know if I've made any assumptions. I mean, for the most part, I've just created hypotheses and then tested them. But there might be some deeply ingrained assumptions about how they work that I've ingrained in myself, and perhaps I'm not going to question them when I should. We shall see. Okay, looking for terminals, QR codes. I'll try not to sprint too crazy fast. This game is filled with a lot of fine details, so it's easy to miss stuff. And certainly if there's a tiny walkie-talkie on the ground, I'm probably not going to see it. Is this brick wall trying to tell me something? Is this like the shape of a US state or something? What does it mean? I can usually jump up on these. Yeah. Can I get in there? Is there something back there? This female voice that speaks from the abnormalities. It speaks with a different tone to the other wretches in this place. Female voice. I think it's talking about Alexandra. that's about it. Wait a minute. This building looks different. This one, what's up with that? What's in there? Is that a place where I just solved a puzzle? Oh, it is.
Pretty blue glow.
Yeah, I think that's it for this place. I mean, I'm still missing the star, but... Oh. Oh, I thought that went somewhere. Damn it. I thought I'd done something special. I think finding that walkie-talkie was special enough. That would have been very easy to miss. This could allow me to get somewhere. Ooh. This opens up a whole bunch of possibilities.
Oh, do you think I could jump? If I jump off this pillar right here in front of me, do you think I can get inside of that thing in front of me? I probably can't jump up to it.
Okay, let me try sprinting. I think it's gonna put me over it, though. Oh!
I might be able to jump. Like, I don't know if I can... How fast... Can I stop instantly?
Okay, you do have air control. Let me try jumping after I hit it. Oh, no. I think there actually might be something in there. I just hope I don't end up getting stuck. Ooh! Oh! It's already open. God damn it. Okay. It's not the end of the world, though, because if I can actually get up there, that could allow me to get somewhere else. So now I don't want to jump inside of it, I want to jump... Wow, where's this going, though? This isn't really connected to anything, is it? Not really. I could maybe... If I jump onto this, I could go around here and then jump onto this, and then jump onto this, and then maybe make my way here and then onto the roof, but what's the point? I already read this, right? Yeah. Although it's funny that this message is right here. Then yeah, what's the point of being up there? I mean, I guess I could continue this way, but then where does that lead? This probably goes somewhere, I just don't know where. I could conceivably jump down here and then onto this and then onto this, but then that goes nowhere. Yeah, I don't see the point. One more try. Alright, forget it. Let's see if there's another place, though, real quick, where I can just jump up on stuff. I don't think I can jump up on this. No. Any other ramps? It's probably where the freaking star is. Some weird jumping puzzle thing.
I don't know. Who knows? Somebody knows. But I don't want to know, because I want to figure it out for myself. I'm sure there's a wiki that has, like, every single secret in the entire game. But screw that, that's no fun. Anything new for me, computer? Nope. Oh yeah, let's go open up our box. Oh shit, four shapes. Do you think I can do it? This might be harder than Dark Souls. So I wonder what happens if you don't, like, if I didn't have this connector unlocked and I went to the area where I had to actually use the connector? What would have happened? Like, would have just prevented me from going to this area? I don't know. And what do you know, the next place requires both connectors and blocks. Okay, well, I think I'll end this episode here. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.